event is the day, time of the Babylon harvest, and we are still cutting corn with the bid. Combine's still running. Yesterday we had the breakdown and got that fixed, parts running, and we harvested pretty late at night. Got to see the cool nighttime video with all the tractors loading the grain at the end of the day into the bin. And we're cutting corn today, so that is good. Got a few more long rows to go. I'm cutting six here, and then there's 12 more out there. And then we'll be into the short rows on this field. Hopefully, I'm thinking we'll finish this field today and then maybe move the operation to one or two different locations, and we'll continue to fill this bin for a little bit, but then we'll be hauling back to the elevator after that. But I think this is going to be my last day on the farm this year for harvest anyway. See how it goes. Hopefully get some more good drone shots and maybe a load on the go today. I don't know if you can see them in the distance. Maybe I can zoom in on this, but the neighbors are going too, in beans. Two of them at the same time. That's pretty cool. I think everybody's red too. They went red this year. Or at least partially red. So that's cool.
Thank you.
this one. Swing by, sweet chariot, come for to carry corn home. Swing by, sweet chariot, come for to carry corn home. I looked over yonder and what did I see? Big red corn come to carry for me.
I don't know if you can see it.
just under an eighth of a tank. It's time to fuel up and get some lunch. So this is what we call the hopper, and that's where the grain comes up, the clean grain comes up the elevator and into the hopper, and there's two little augers at the bottom down there that pull the grain over to this auger, and that auger is the one that runs it out to the grain cart. You can see there's some steps in there. There's parts that need greased and worked on from time to time. And up there, the little black paddle on that other side is a sensor that measures when the corn hits it. It beeps inside and tells you that it's full, or at least it's supposed to.
Thank you.
Well, it's lunchtime and we're talking about what to do this afternoon, but I thought I would go up here and show you guys how much corn is in this bin. And I really don't remember how much it is, but you can see through the door and tell that there's quite a bit in there. About a foot from the top or less, or a little bit more, I mean. So now you can see the remainder of the field that we've been working in today. That's corn out there. To the right is the beans, which is green. And as we pull back, we can see the shed where the equipment is kept and where we're often working on repairs. And then in the bottom there, you can see the bigger bin. And there's an auger running from those bins, or from that bin to the orange wagons, where they are coring the bin, removing some of the corn to get fines and cob and trash out of there that will help the bin keep better. That grain will go back to the elevator, and we'll put new grain in on the top. And again, that's just because the grain will keep better with less of that trash in there. Be able to store it longer with and have better quality when you take it out. Flying over the rows that we've been working on over the past couple of days and have had breakdowns, so it's taken quite a long time. I believe if we got up early and ran all day on this field without a breakdown and with carts loading on the go, we could do this field in one day. We've almost done it before, but this year it took us several days. You could see the cart down at the end of the field that I was loading into until late in the day, until they got that bin finished off, and then I loaded on the go. And then there's that bare spot that I was talking about where water sat and damaged some of the crops. The water sat there at a time when the plants were very small, and so they didn't have the health to last, so it killed off some of the plants and kind of stunted the growth of some of the ones around the outside of essentially what's a puddle there in the field. And then here, coming back to the lot, you can see the 1420 that I ran last night. It's still sitting out there. I was running that while the six row was being repaired. Well, let's turn the auger off. Make sure nobody's behind us. We'll put the auger away. Turn the thresher on. Turn the header on. Throttle all the way up. Saw it go up to 300 earlier, which I felt like was probably just a glitch or something. I was running a little bit slower, so maybe the calculations were off or something. But that's pretty cool to see 300 bushels an acre in a field. It's good black soil. That's why it's even close to that. But we're going to do these two more rounds. We're going to, the bin is full, I think, and so we're going to take the rest of this to the elevator, which means we're loading it onto wagons. And Poppy and Chris, maybe myself, will drive those up there. And then I think we'll move to another field, hopefully, maybe before the sun goes down, might be in the twilight, because we still got to go to the elevator. So, yeah, it'll probably be dark by the time we move, or maybe they'll move early in the morning, not sure. This is my last full day of harvest this year. A fine, good harvest this year. I mean, obviously the yields are good, so that always makes it kind of exciting. And then seeing all the tractors last night was really exciting. There was ups and downs because this combine was broke down yesterday. And this morning it ran really good. Then this afternoon we changed some settings, try to see if we could clean up some of the loss that we were getting. And it seemed like it was going okay, but then we got into this corn that's just a little bit wetter. This is like 17% moisture. And all of a sudden, it seemed like we were losing a lot of corn out the back. The cobs would come out with like a whole couple of rows of kernels on them. And the loss meter was way up. Stopping for that, changing the settings, trying to get that figured out. Spent some time on that, eventually figured that out and got it running, had the rotor, turned the rotor back up to a higher speed, and that helped out. Then we ran a little while longer, and then Chris noticed that there was this corn just flowing out of the side of the combine, just a little spray, constant spray. And it turned out that there was a hole worn in the side of the metal on the grain elevator in the side of the combine. And so we actually put like heating duct tape over it, and I think it might have worked a little bit. There was still some coming out, but it was like a more manageable amount, or acceptable, I guess. So I'm hoping that duct tape, or yeah, heating duct tape, or stove tape, some people call it, is still holding. That does a good trick. It looked like it was going to be good, so I guess it just depends on how much pressure and how much wear the corn puts on that tape as the elevator shoots the corn past it. It kind of like bounces there. That's what causes that wear in the first place, and it wore through in a thin sheet metal. So we patched that up. We got back to running, and I did about a round, and then I had a warning light going off telling me that something about an air, engine air, and I hadn't seen that before, and Chris didn't know what it was. And I tried running slower, and the yields were really, really high, so I thought maybe I just needed to slow down. But it still kept going off, and eventually I stopped and went out on the back of the combine, and you could see like leaves and dust and debris packed around the air intake back there, and I just brushed that off. And that got me going again, but that was just one more stop, you know, for the day that slowed us down. We should have been done here already. But, hey, everybody's safe, and the corn is getting harvested, so all in all, I think it's been good. I see tractors of green, red tractors too. I see them work for me and you, and I think to myself, what a wonderful harvest. I think to myself, what a wonderful harvest. Today was brought to us via the elevator from Franklin United Methodist Church, which is where Sandy and I got married. They've got John 21:17 C. Jesus said to him, "Feed my sheep." And there was a big ham and cheese sandwich, and an apple, a banana, chips, Chex Mix, a cookie. So that was pretty awesome. And a water bottle, which was good. So thank you to Franklin United Methodist Church. Greens and reds are having a competition. How Poppy got through the elevator with a busted fuel line. I wonder when he figured that out. If it busted on the way and he just drove through the elevator, or if it busted pulling off the scale, or if it died pulling off the scale. That would have been pretty lucky. Well, we'll have to come back and get it. So we had a breakdown.
on the 4430. Got a, is it on this side or the other side? Got a fuel leak. Right up in there. So, Poppy and I are gonna tow it home. We're debating about who gets to tow and who gets to be the towee. Towing it home with the 64410 and a chain. So we'll see how that goes.